Sawadee and good evening. Welcome to Thai PBS World Tonight. I'm your host, Tulip, Naksompop, Blauw. We will report to you the latest update on COVID-19 situation in Thailand, especially the official number, official figures updated by CCSA every day. So at 11:30 every day, the Center of COVID-19 Situation Administration will give a press briefing that give you a total number of cases all over the country every day. And today, the latest number, Thailand records new 819 cases. And most of them are local transmissions. We're talking about 808 cases today. And there are 11 imported cases. There is one new death, though, rising the death toll to 76. The latest fatality was a 56-year-old Thai man who was bedridden with a stroke. He began to develop symptoms on January 22nd and received treatment in Kathumban Hospital in Samut Sakhon province until his death. The new infections today bring the number of the new outbreak to 11,228, while the cumulative total is now 15,465. The new cases announced by the CCSA today include the infections reported in Samut Sakhon last night. The number was 792. Among them, 714 were found through proactive screening and 78 were diagnosed in hospitals, with majority of them are migrant workers. Now, even though that number is still record three digits, but CCSA said that they are planning to propose some relaxation of the restriction, and they will discuss that this Friday, including the school reopen in some certain provinces, but probably not in Samut Sakhon yet. Thailand Center for COVID-19 Situation Administration will meet this Friday to consider easing restrictions that has been imposed nationally since the onset of the second COVID-19 outbreak in mid-December. CCSA said that three major issues will be considered: reopening of schools, dining and drinking hours at entertainment venues, restaurants and street food stalls, and proposed plans and guidelines for the easing of restrictions. For in-school classes suspended since mid-December, Dr. Thuisin, the CCSA spokesperson, said that they are expected to resume in all provinces except Samut Sakhon, where there is a serious concern over the spread of the virus among students using public transport. Alternate day class attendance, social distancing, and online learning may still be needed in schools in the four red zones of Bangkok, Samut Prakan, Nonthaburi, and Pathum Thani province. Easing the restrictions will be based on separating the country into different zones in line with the severity of the pandemic. Samut Sakhon is a maximum controlled and restricted area. Maximum control area include Bangkok, Samut Prakan, Nonthaburi, and Pathum Thani, while controlled areas cover 20 provinces with maximum surveillance area in 17 provinces and surveillance areas in 35 provinces. In the case of Samut Sakhon, which is the highest maximum control area, the CCSA will seek to ease restrictions on shopping malls, eateries, and markets, allowing them to operate until 9 p.m. Takeaway orders for eateries on factories which meet safety standards and nurseries and care centers for the elderly. And for the maximum control areas such as Bangkok, Samut Prakan, Nonthaburi, and Pathum Thani, it will be proposed that pubs, karaoke bars, and eateries should be allowed to open until 11 p.m. with live music, but no dancing. For maximum control and control area, the number of attendees at the seminars should not exceed 100, but no dancing or music. In maximum surveillance and surveillance areas, the number of attendees at seminars is limited to 300, with music permitted, but no dancing. So there you go. This Friday, they will have a discussion, and we will know pretty soon maybe following day or the end of Friday, whether there will be any more relaxation of all this restriction regarding COVID-19 measures. And let's go to Samut Sakhon province, which is the area that still record highest number daily. The latest one last night was 792. It's made a total number of the country going up every day. And the senior health official of Samut Sakhon province said the situation is still very worrisome. He is the provincial public health official of Samut Sakhon province, and he expressed serious concern over a high-risk group of about 15,000 people who are still traveling and working as normal and risking transmission of coronavirus to others. Dr. Naredrit Kattasima said that based on the assumption that there are at least 3 people in close contact with each of the 5,000 infected people already identified in the coastal province. He said that these high-risk people pose a real challenge to health officials in their efforts to contain the spread of the virus. He reiterated the need for full cooperation from factories, which hired many migrant workers, agencies supervising industrial standards in factories, and the Federation of Thai Industries, to make sure that employers strictly observe social distancing among their employees and mandate the wearing of face masks. He pointed out that the cramped conditions in the migrant workers' dormitories are ideal environments for the spread of virus. Regarding those already infected, Dr. Naredrit noted that severe cases are minimal with a low rate of mortality, but the virus tend to spread quickly. He recommended that health officials meet to assess the mass screening program and whether it should be repeated every 2 weeks, as he think it cannot be continued endlessly due to the huge cost, estimated at about 1,600 baht per head, including labor cost and equipment. So he suggests that more effective preventive measures must be developed. Now, let's go to Rayong province. Even though the situation in Samut Sakhon doesn't look like it's getting any better, it looks somewhat stabilized though. But Rayong province is thinking about easing their restriction very soon, especially for the 10 types of businesses. The Communicable Disease Control Committee has agreed to allow 10 types of businesses in Rayong province to reopen from Wednesday onward, which is today. The governor of Rayong, Chan Na Yiem Sang, said that since the number of new cases in the province is low, the following businesses will be allowed to reopen. We are talking about shopping centers, the shops that selling construction materials and mobile phone outlets, Thai massage shops, beauty clinics, museum, learning parks, learning centers or similar establishments, public libraries, parks, natural attractions and beaches, sport fields and exercise grounds. However, team sports is not allowed yet. Golf courses, shooting ranges, flea markets. Chana said that the businesses operators still have to strictly follow preventive measures and they will be immediately closed if they violate the rules. He added that reopening was not mandatory and depends on each business readiness. Meanwhile, Rayong officials on Friday will look into whether schools should reopen on February 1st and whether interprovincial travel should be allowed. Now, from Rayong, let's go to Phuket province. As we know that Phuket has placed some restriction from people in some certain provinces that they have to quarantine themselves when they get into Phuket area. But the latest report is that the Phuket is seeking to lift quarantine measures for visitors from 21 provinces. The governor of Phuket, Narong Wun Siu, said that the province will relax its quarantine measures for visitors from Bangkok and another 20 provinces. The 14-day quarantine measures will be lifted for people from Tak, Saraburi, Pathum Thani, Ayutthaya, Supanburi, Lopburi, Singhburi, Kanchanaburi, Nakhon Nayok, Ranong, Chumphon, Prajob Kirikan, Sakao, Ratchaburi, เพชรบุรีสมุทรสงครามอ่างทองฉะเชิงเทรา Prachinburi, and Samut Sakhon, as well as Bangkok. Rayong said that visitors from these provinces are required to strictly follow the measures, including wearing masks, avoiding crowds, and observing their health. However, travelers from seven maximum control provinces, which is Samut Sakhon, Nakhon Pathom, Nonthaburi, Jantaburi, Chonburi, Rayong, and Trat, will still have to undergo a 14-day quarantine. Meanwhile, Phuket Tourist Association's president, Phumikit Rakdangam, said that the vaccine may help the tourism industry recover, especially if foreigners are allowed in from October onwards. He said that if every foreigner entering Phuket was vaccinated and up to 70% of the island's population was inoculated, then people will be confident that tourists will not bring new infections. He said that the government should start planning to reopen the country soon and come up with the clear answers for the private sector. Otherwise, all tourism-related businesses will die. So we have to see how is the inoculation plan will be like. Right now, what we know is that Thailand already placed order for the vaccines that enough to inoculate about half of the population. But the vaccine that developed by Chulalongkorn University is entering the human trial phase very soon, and there is a chance that if it's a success by the end of this year, we might see something come out from Chulalongkorn University as well. So we have a lot of things to look up to in terms of vaccination, but the plan is not really panned out yet. But the Prime Minister said if it's not safe, he will not make it. If the vaccine is not safe, he will not let the Thai people risk their life with the vaccine. So he have to be sure that it's safe, then it will be allowed to give out in the country. So right now we have AstraZeneca that already get approved from FDA, so it should be the inoculation program should start probably in February. And we have Sinovac, which on the plan will arrive in February, but it doesn't get approved from the FDA yet. So we just have to wait and see. And we have many other things also beside the government also allow other organizations to import the vaccine themselves as long as that vaccine get approved by FDA from the original country and get approved by FDA in Thailand. So we have to wait and see. There's a lot of options here. So I think a lot of private hospitals is trying to see whether they can do something about it. And that's all the news we have for you about COVID-19 outbreak in Thailand for today. You can follow us on Facebook. You can follow us on Twitter and on our website, thaibsworld.com. We have more than just COVID-19 news. We have political news, we have lifestyle, we have travel, food, and everything related to Thailand. So check it out. And we'll come back to see you again. Khun Nat Bunna will give you the update during the day tomorrow at 1 p.m. สวัสดีค่ะ.